بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين وخاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المظلومين ولا سيما حجة الله في الأرضين وقائم الهدى المهديين الحجة ابن الحسن العسكري السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله السلام على غريب كربلاء السلام على شهيد نينوى السلام على قتيل العدا السلام على مسلوب الرضا السلام على ابن فاطمة الزهراء Move your hearts towards Karbala. Give your salam to your Imam. All together. As-salamu ala al-Husayn. With one loud voice, all together. As-salamu ala الحسين وعلى علي ابن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين السلام على أخي الحسين أبي الفضل العباس قطيع اليدين السلام على أخت الحسين غريبة كربلاء زينب الكبرى يا ليتنا كنا معكم all together يا ليتنا كنا معكم فنفوز فوزا عظيما إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا آل محمد أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين. يقول سيدنا ومولانا جعفر بن محمد الصادق صلوات الله وسلامه عليه: تلك المجالس أحبها فأحيوا أمرنا، رحم الله من أحيا أمرنا. Awadiya Imam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam, says, I love these majalis. So keep our issue alive. May Allah have mercy on those who revive our issue and mission. To hasten the holy appearance of Sahib al-Zaman alayhi salam and to be among his supporters and companions, please recite one loud salawat. Another louder salawat to have all your hajat, to answer all your prayers. This is the majlis of Imam Hussein. It needs a louder salawat, inshallah, to answer all your prayers. Inshallah, have all your hajat and acceptance of all your a'mal. Another louder salawat. Our dear Imam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam, says, I love these majalis. Why? Because these majalis revives the issue of Ahlulbayt alayhi salam and the mission of Ahlulbayt. When Muharram starts, these days of Ashura come and we start coming to these majalis, actually we are entering the school of Karbala, which is an ocean of lessons and morals for us. And inshallah, me and you, dear brothers and sisters, every night, we will learn a new lesson from this rich school of Karbala, which will enlighten our heart, guide our soul, and take us towards iman, guidance, and eternal happiness, inshallah, in dunya and akhirah. Yesterday we started, and we had the first lesson from Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And Imam Hussein alayhi salam, this lesson identified for us the most dangerous disease, the most dangerous spiritual disease, which was the main cause for the tragedy of Karbala. What was that disease? All of you were here last night. The love of dunya, the excessive love of dunya, the adoration of dunya, which was from the beginning of the creation, from the time of Habil and Qabil, and then it continued to Karbala, it continued to our time, it will be until the time of the appearance of Sahib al-Asr wal-Zaman, Ajjallahu ta'ala farajahu al-Sharif. So it's with us, it's living with us, it's around us, so we should be very careful. We should know the signs and the indications of this disease. Imagine you will be very worried if you have a physical disease. If you feel a pain in your heart, you will go straight away towards the doctor. But if it's a spiritual disease, you should be more careful. It should be, give it more importance, because it affects this life and the afterlife, dunya and akhirah. And our Imam alayhi salam, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, because we may not feel the pain of the spiritual disease, Imam alayhi salam identified for us the indications. What were the indications that we talked about last night? The indications of this disease of hubb al-dunya. First, their iman is there by tongue, only by tongue. Second, their priority is for their livelihood and living. And third, they cannot remain steadfast in facing the tests and the trials. These are the three indications of this disease. Imam is giving us these indications just to treat ourselves, that we know that if we have any of these indications, to go and treat it. The treatment is the important stage now. before it covers all your heart, it affects all your heart, and then it may reach to the stage of sealing, khatam, which is actually the spiritual death of your heart. So Imam alayhi salam told us about this. He identified first this disease for us. He gave us the indications. Yesterday we talked about this, and we reached to the third stage, which is the treatment. And we started the treatment last night, and we said that the treatment that the doctors of soul, our dear imams, gave to us. What is the treatment? We said that our imams, alayhi salam, says is the treatment is the continuous connection with Allah and Imam Hussein, alayhi salam. And we said this holy hadith from our imam, Imam al-Rida, alayhi salam, Gharib al-Ghuraba, Gharib Tus. He says, salawatullah wa salamu alayhi, من جلس مجلسا يحيى فيه ذكرنا لم يمت قلبه يوم تموت القلوب. Whoever attends our majalis, like you, alhamdulillah, you are attending the majalis of Ahlulbayt. Whoever attends our majalis, his heart will not die when hearts die. When the other hearts die because of the love of dunya, this adoration of dunya, your hearts, because you attend the majalis of Imam Hussein, will remain alive. You will be not infected by this disease. When you attend the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, when you cry for Imam Hussein alayhi salam, when you shed tears for Imam Hussein alayhi salam, these tears will wash these layers over your heart. They wash them layer over layer. And it removes all these layers and it enlightens your heart. So the treatment, as we said, is this continuous, constant connection with Allah and Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And we are in the school of Karbala. Who is our teacher? Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So in this school of Karbala, in the most important night in Karbala, in the night of Ashura, the most difficult night, where 30,000 enemies were surrounding the tents, Imam Hussein alayhi salam taught us to keep this connection, this constant connection, even in the most difficult night, the most difficult condition and situation. And these are lessons for us to learn from it, to apply it today, in our day-to-day life, to have this connection with Ahlul Bayt and Imam Hussein alayhi salam, to keep us away from all these trials of this obsessive life, to keep this light in our hearts. When you have the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, you always have that light in your heart. Even if you are living in the West, you are living in the West. Even if you are living in a very far town in the countryside. Even if there is no Husayniyas or mosques or Islamic centers in that far town. Even if there is only two Shia families in this town, you keep this connection. May Allah have rahmah and mercy on the soul of Hajj Mirza Hassan bin Dahneem. This Hajj Hassan, in 1968, here in Perth, before 48 years, where there were no Shia community, very few families, he started the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam here. And he kept this connection and this constant relation with Imam Hussein alayhi salam and with Allah in those difficult days. He started the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam in his own house. Even with very minimum modest resources, he used his son's bedroom as a prayer room for the majalis. He used his lounge as a Husayniyah. And he took out all the furniture of his house outside the house to the backyard to make the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. In those difficult days, he kept that connection with Imam Hussein alayhi salam and with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these majalis continued and continued from that day. It were the first majalis done here in Perth. For 48 years now. Now we are 2016. 48 years it continued and continued. And alhamdulillah, now his friends, his sons, and now the dear brothers mu'mineen in Aqwa are continuing these majalis now in Muharram 2016. So Mirza Hassan bin Dahneem, in those difficult days, he kept that relation. What is the result of that? These majalis that we see today. He kept that relation, that connection. Who taught him? Where did he learn from? From Imam Hussein, from the school of Karbala and the school of Ashura. When you come to the school of Karbala in the night of Muharram, you want to look at Imam Hussein alayhi salam, you will see that connection. You will see only Salat and Quran. You look at Imam Hussein alayhi salam, you will see Salat and Quran. In that difficult situation, those enemies, all of them, they are surrounding 30,000, his tents and his camp from all sides, and they want to attack him. He asked them to delay the fight till tomorrow morning. Why? Because he wants to read Quran and Salat. In that difficult situation, in that night of Ashura, if you enter to the tent of Imam Hussein, you will see him praying. You enter the tent of Abbas, you will see him praying. You enter the tent of Zainab, sisters, you will see her praying. You enter to the tent of Akbar, you will see him praying. All praying and reading Quran. This is the school of Karbala. When you want to look at Imam Hussein, Imam Hussein and Salat and Quran are together. They are connected together. You cannot separate them from each other. So Imam Hussein alayhi salam, he identified for us the most dangerous disease of the spirit and the soul. What is that disease? We've just talked about it. The love of dunya. This obsessive love of dunya. And he identified the treatment as well in the night of Ashura, which is the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is Salat and Quran. I'll tell you this story. One day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi was sitting with his companions. And those days, the Arabs used to use pots, copper pots for cooking in Arabia. And usually these copper pots used to get rusted. And when a copper pot gets rusted, what do you do for it? You polish it so you can use it again. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi told them, do you know that hearts get rusted as well? إِنَّ الْقُلُوبَ لَتَصْدَى. All of them, they were shocked and surprised. They are talking about pots. How, ya Rasulullah? How it gets rusted? And then, because they are connected to that idea of pots, how we can polish it? When this heart is rusted, how we can polish it? They said, فَمَا جَلَاءُهَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. How we can polish it? He said, قِرَاءَةُ الْقُرْآنِ وَذِكْرُ الْمَوْتِ. If you want to polish your heart, polish it with the words of Allah, with the Holy Quran. Because if you don't fill this heart with the words of Allah, it will be filled with the words of others. And day after day, these words of others and this material life will make these layers of rust over your heart. And if you don't treat it, it will reach to the spiritual death of your heart or to the stage of khatm, sealing. that we talked about. These days you come to some people, you ask them, dear brother, how many verses of the Holy Quran did you recite today? Because you have to recite, because it nourishes your heart day and night, and it gives it light, this Holy Quran. He will tell you, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, I recited Quran in Shahr Ramadan. In the month of Ramadan, I recited Quran. I don't know why, like some people, they think that reciting Quran is just like fasting. It's only for the month of Ramadan. But when you come to the school of Karbala and Imam Hussein alayhi salam, in the night of Ashura, you will see Quran. You will see Salat. It's narrated in the narrations that in that night, it was heard from the camp of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, a loud sound of humming, like a hive bee. كطنين النحل in the narration. Because of their reciting of the Holy Quran. Every tent, there is a group of companions, they are reciting Quran. Ahlulbayt, they are reciting Quran. So because this sound was very powerful, it went to the camp of Bani Umayyah. See the effect of the Holy Quran. It affected the hearts of some of the soldiers of the camp of Umar ibn Sa'd. So they got affected by that Quran. In that dark night, they came, they used the darkness, and they joined the camp of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And they became from the followers of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. See, here is the treatment by the Holy Quran. How Imam Hussein alayhi salam treated them by the Holy Quran. They had this disease of the love of dunya. This love of dunya captivated their hearts and made them in the camp of Bani Umayyah. And the Quran of Imam Hussein alayhi salam freed their hearts and freed their souls and made them join Imam Hussein and attain the high rank of martyrdom and shahada, and they became from the martyrs of Karbala. This is how Imam Hussein alayhi salam used the Holy Quran to treat this disease, this very dangerous disease of the love of dunya. When you come to the school of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and in this majalis, we are in the school of Imam Hussein. We came to learn for our life. Imam Hussein alayhi salam teaches us how to preserve the Holy Quran. There is no Imam like Imam Hussein alayhi salam, who concentrated and eschewed this continuous relation with the Holy Quran. There is no Imam like Imam Hussein. There is no Ma'soom like Imam Hussein alayhi salam, who remained reciting the Holy Quran even after his martyrdom. The head of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein on the top of that lance was reciting the Holy Quran. He was reciting Surah Al-Kahf and repeating this verse, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. What keeps you away from reciting the Holy Quran? What are your excuses? If your Imam was reciting on the top of the lance, what are our excuses to keep us away from the Holy Quran? This is the school of Karbala. You may hear a lot of narrations about the virtue of reciting Quran, how it revives the heart, and how it gets you close towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when you hear that from the lips of Aba Abdullah on that lance, this narration will affect your heart. This is the school of Karbala. It teaches us how to connect with Allah through Quran and through Salat. So this is the first step in this school. How to connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Quran and through Salat. The second step of treatment, and this is how Ahlulbayt alayhi salam taught us, how to keep this continuous connection with Imam Hussein alayhi salam. continuous, constant connection with Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Even daily connection with Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Because if you have daily connection with Imam Hussein, you will have constant protection for your heart. It will always nourish your heart. It will always enlighten your heart. And you will not get infected by this dangerous disease of the love of dunya. That's why our Imams alayhi salam, and please listen to this, directed us to do sujood every day 34 times on the turba of Hussein, on the clay of Karbala. 34 times. We have 17 rik'ah every day. In every rik'ah, how many sujood? 2 sujood. 17 times 2. 34 times Ahlulbayt directing you to do sujood every day on the clay of Karbala. Why? Because they want to remind you, this is the same clay, the same turba that Imam Hussein alayhi salam shed his blood upon to revive this salat. He sacrificed with his own blood for this salat. He sacrificed with his family and children and the hands of Abbas and the tears of Ruqayya. He sacrificed with his baby Ali Asghar for this salat. So you can come today and you can stand in front of Qibla and you can perform your salat. If it would not be for the sacrifice of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, we'll have no salat today and no Islam today. It was the sacrifice of Imam Hussein salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi that kept this salat and kept this Islam. That's why it's narrated by our dear Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam, السجود على تربة الحسين يخرق الحجب السبع. Prostrating on the clay of Karbala, the turba of Imam Hussein, penetrates the 7 veils. It removes all the veils and it shows you the light, because إِنَّ الْحُسَيْنَ مِصْبَاحُ الْهُدَى وَسَفِينَةُ الْنَجَاةِ. Verily Hussein is the light of guidance and the ark of salvation. That's why in Najaf, in the holy city of Najaf, one of our biggest muraji', in every salat, before starting the salat, before doing takbiratul ihram, Allahu Akbar, he will pay his salam to Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and he will say, Sallallahu alayka ya Aba Abdillah. Every salat, big salatul jama'ah in Najaf al-Ashraf, thousands of scholars behind him. So they came to ask him, Mawlana, Shaykhana, every time you want to start salat, you say salam to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Why? He says, because without the sacrifice of Imam Hussein, the blood of Imam Hussein, we'll not have the salat. It was the blood of Imam Hussein that preserved the salat. That's why when you come to one of our greatest muraji', like Ayatullah Bahshat, when he was doing salat, at the last rik'ah of the salat, when you do the salam, when he used to reach to As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi as-salihin, he used to cry so much. He used to cry and cry and then stop. And then he says, As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. His students came to him and said, Mawlana, why here? Why exactly in this phrase, As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi as-salihin? Why are you crying here in this phrase? He said, do you know who is ibadullah as-salihin? Do you know who is al-abdu as-salih? Al-abdu as-salih is the special name of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas alayhi salam. He gave his hands to preserve this salat. What we are giving to preserve this salat? Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas alayhi salam, when they cut his two hands, he cried and shouted, Wallahi inni uhami abadan an dini. By Allah, I will remain defending my religion. He gave his hands to preserve the salat. What we have given to this salat? We come to this salat to pray, we stand in front of Qibla, And all these ideas, thousands of ideas of this material life come to our head, attacks us. Your work, your school, your university, your children, many other things. All of this comes to you. So what should you do? This is how Ahlulbayt teach us. You do, Assalamu alayka Aba Abdullah. You say salam to Imam Hussein. Say salam to Abul Fadl Abbas. When you remember that great sacrifice to revive this salat, when you remember the details of the day of Karbala and how Imam Hussein alayhi salam sacrificed with Ali Asghar for this salat, this emotional, spiritual shock will shock you from the inside and awaken your sleeping heart, so you will go towards salat with remembering Imam Hussein alayhi salam. This is why our Imams alayhi salam tell us to do sujood on the sajda of Karbala. So what we are talking about? We are talking about the treatment. The treatment of this disease of the love of dunya. This disease of the love of dunya, if you want to treat it, first you have to have continuous connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Quran and Salat. Second, you have to have continuous, constant connection to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And this is how our Imams taught us to connect our daily salat to Imam Hussein. How? Through the sujood, sajda, turba of Karbala. Through saying salam to Imam Hussein before we start the salat, mentioning him in our salat. After salat, it's very mustahab, one of the ta'qibat, to say salam to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. To do the ziyarah of Imam Hussein. Even the very little ziyarah that everyone memorizes. I know that you memorize it. As-salamu ala al-Husayn, wa ala Ali ibn al-Husayn, wa ala awlad al-Husayn, wa ala ashab al-Husayn. Very easy. Everyone knows it. When you finish your salat, you remember their sacrifices by this salam. Salamu ala al-Husayn, sacrifices of Husayn. Ala Ali ibn al-Husayn, sacrifices of Ali al-Akbar. وعلى أولاد الحسين, the sacrifice of the infant baby of Imam Hussein. وعلى أصحاب الحسين, the sacrifice of the companions of Imam Hussein. You remember those heroes of Karbala and what they have done for this salat. So you connect to this salat Imam Hussein عليه السلام wanted. This is the first way of connecting to Imam Hussein عليه السلام daily. أهل البيت عليهم السلام to connect us daily. Even they mentioned very minute details of everyday life, like drinking water. How many times you drink water in a day? Many times. They directed us, whenever you drink water, which is a very easy thing, everyone does it many times every day, remember al-Husayn and say salam to Husayn. And do curse on the enemies of Hussein. And teach this to your children by saying Assalamu ala al-Hussein while drinking water. You will take 100,000 hasanat. This is the generosity of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. 100,000 hasanat. Why to deprive yourself of these hasanat? 100,000 hasanat. And teach it to your children. Imagine your child in your house. Whenever he goes to drink water, he is in front of your eyes. You are watching him. He drinks water and said, Salamu ala al-Husayn. If he doesn't know Arabic, he says it in English. Peace be upon you, my dear Husayn. How beautiful it will be. What will be your feeling at that moment? You are seeing your child remembering your Imam and saying salam to him. This is how Ahlulbayt directed us even in the minute details of everyday life. And this is how we should bring up our children. Islamic moral upbringing on the love of Hussein. This love of Hussein will protect them from all the dangers, all the trials and the tests of the life. They will get elder, they will become young men. What will protect them? This love of Hussein. Inshallah, we'll talk about this in details, about the Islamic moral upbringing of our children, inshallah, in the night of the son of Hussein, who was brought up on this Islamic moral upbringing in the night of Al-Akbar alayhi salam. We'll specify that night to talk about the Islamic moral upbringing for our children on the love of Ahlul Bayt and on the love of Imam Hussein alayhi salam by the blessing of one loud salawat. Inshallah, to have the intercession of Imam Hussein in the day of judgment, another louder salawat. So, this was daily connection to Imam Hussein. We have to have this daily connection to protect ourselves from this very dangerous disease, the love of dunya. And there is another connection Ahlulbayt taught us, which is weekly connection. Ahlulbayt, alayhi salam, they are very merciful. We are their Shias. They specified one night every week to do the ziyarah of Imam Hussein, alayhi salam. What is that night? Yes, brother? Ahsant, Laylatul Jum'ah. May Allah reward you, Sayyid. Laylatul Jum'ah, Thursday evening, Shabi Jum'ah, Laylatul Jum'ah is the special night of the ziyarah of Imam Hussein and the majalis of Imam Hussein. They directed us towards this, the weekly ziyarah and the weekly majalis. Why? Because it's narrated in our narrations that this Laylatul Jum'ah is the special night of the ziyarat of Imam Mahdi alayhi salam for the shrine of his grandfather Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Every Laylatul Jum'ah, Al-Mahdi alayhi salam will go to Karbala and hold the zarih of Imam Hussein with his hands. And as he recites in Ziyaratil Jami'ah, فَلَا أَنْدُبَنَّكَ صَبَاحًا وَمَسَاءً يَا جَدَّاهُ وَلَا أَبْكِيَنَّ عَلَيْكَ بَدَلَ الدُّمُوعِ الدَّمَى. I will mourn for you, my father, day and night, and I will weep for you with tears of blood. And there he cries and do the ziyarah and do the majlis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam at the dharih of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. If you are somewhere and you don't have someone to recite majlis for you, just recite ziyarat al-nahiy al-muqaddas. Ziyarat al-Nahya al-Muqaddas for Sahib al-Asr wal-Zaman. This is how Imam Zaman expressed his feelings towards his father, Imam Hussein alayhi salam. When you recite this ziyarah, it's majlis of aza by itself. As-salamu ala al-madlumi bila nasir. As-salamu ala al-mughassali bidam al-jirah. Peace you be upon you who were washed by the blood of your wounds. As-salamu ala Ali al-Kabir. As-salamu ala al-Tifl al-Saghir. Imam Zaman cries for Abdullah al-Radi' Ali al-Asghar. This is the weekly majalis. And according to Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam and the riwayat we have from Ahlul Bayt, this majalis is the most powerful manifestation for this connection. If we have treatment, if you want treatment, if you want this medicine for your soul, the best medicine is this majalis of Ahlul Bayt, salawatullah wa salamu alayhi. Imam Rida alayhi salam says, we've just mentioned the narration, man jalasa majlisan yuhya fihi dhikruna lam yamut qalbuhu yawma tamutu al-qulub. Whoever attends our majalis, his heart will never die when other hearts die. When other hearts die of this dunya, they are overwhelmed with this obsessive dunya, your heart will remain alive because you are attending the majalis of Hussein. And when you come to the narrations of Ahlul Bayt about this majalis, you see that the most powerful manifestation of this majalis is crying and weeping. All the ahadith, tens of the ahadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, is only about crying and weeping for Abu Abdullah. And the great, great thawab of this crying and weeping. This brother who just was the MC mentioned very nice hadith about Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, about how this crying will forgive all your sins. Imam Ali al-Sajjad, Ali Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, says for his mentioning, please one loud salawat. our dear Imam, Imam Sajjad alayhi salam says, مَا مِن مُؤْمِن دَمَعَتْ عَيْنَاهُ دَمْعَ لِقَتْلِ الْحُسَيْنِ إِلَّا بَوَّأَهُ اللَّهُ بِهَا فِي الْجَنَّةِ غُرَفًا يَسْكُنُهَا أَحْقَابًا. This is the mu'min sense of the mu'min people. When they hear the name of Hussein, their hearts move. They say salawat. Imam Sajjad alayhi salam says, every mu'min who shed a tear, only one tear, for the killing of Hussein alayhi salam, by this one tear, Allah will accommodate him in the elevated rooms in paradise. What a great thawab. By one tear. Imam alayhi salam, Imam al-Rida, our eighth Imam, he tells Ibn Shabib, Ibn Shabib enters to his majlis. He tells him, Yabna Shabib, in bakayta ala al-Husayn, hatta tasira dumu'uk ala khaddayk, ghafar Allahu lak kulla dhanbin adhnabtah, saghiran kana aw kabira, qalilan kana aw kathira. What a great thawab. If you cry, if you shed tears for Hussein alayhi salam, so that your tears roll down your cheeks, Allah will forgive every sin you have committed. The major ones and the minor ones. No sin will remain. This is the great thawab of crying. When you hear all these hadith, tens of hadith about the crying and the reward of crying, you start to study this school of crying and the effects of this school of crying. And what are the tears and what is the crying that Ahlulbayt alayhi salam want from us? What is that crying that changed the heart and make this move and this change from the emotional change to the intellectual change? Yes, right. The love of Hussein dominates your heart. But how to move this love from the side of emotions, heart, to here, to the side of intellect. It becomes intellectual. Like those ones who had the call of Hussein in the day of Ashura. They were in the camp of Ibn Ziyad. But they saw the infant baby slaughtered. And Imam Hussein was alone, calling, هَلْ مِن نَاصِرٍ يَنْصُرُنَا هَلْ مِن مُحَامِي يُحَامِي عَن بَنَاتِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Is there any helper to help us? Is there anyone to defend the daughters of Rasulullah? They are the daughters of Rasulullah, sitting afraid in the tents, no one to defend them. At that moment, Abu al-Harth al-Ghaffari, he was in the camp of Ibn Ziyad Bani Umayyah. His heart was broken. And he was crying for Imam Hussein alayhi salam. We want to know what are the tears that Ahlulbayt alayhi salam want from us. The tears which will make this great reward. It's narrated in the narrations that many in the camp of Umar bin Sa'd, they were crying for Imam Hussein. But they were still in the side of Umar bin Sa'd. They didn't move, they didn't change. Another narration from Hussein bin Abdullah, Al-Husayn bin Abdullah, he said, I saw on the hill near the battlefield many horse riders. They left the battlefield and they were raising their hands in dua for Imam Hussein and they were crying, Ya Allah, please, please protect Imam Hussein. And they were not doing anything. And then they raided the tents of the daughters of Rasulullah and they bent it and they didn't do anything. What is this crying? What's the benefit of this crying? While this Abu al-Harth al-Ghaffari, when he heard the call of Imam Hussein, and this is the crying that Imam Hussein wants from us. The tear of change, which will change your heart, and this change will come to your mind, and you will move a step forward, a practical moving forward. His heart was broken. He told his brother, you see, this is the son of Rasulullah. And these are the daughters of Rasulullah. And look what we are doing. He said, what you are going to do? He said, I'm going to support Hussein. He said, I'm going with you. So these two brothers are called Al-Akhawan Al-Ghaffariyan. They moved from this camp to this camp and they supported Imam Hussein and they became from the martyrs of Karbala. Now you go to Karbala, you go to the shrine of Imam Hussein, then there is the small shrine of Ali Akbar, then the shrine of the Shuhada. Inshallah, may Allah grant you all the chance to visit that holy shrine. Inshallah, Arba'een is coming and all the hearts is moving towards Karbala. Inshallah, you will be from those ones who moved to Karbala. You will see that shrine of the Shuhada and Qasim and all the names of the Shuhada, 72, are written there. And these two brothers, Al-Ghaffariyan, are written there. That tear, that crying, changed them, changed their heart. They moved from the emotional side to the intellectual side. They made the change. And this is the change that Ahlulbayt alayhi salam want from us. This is the change that Imam Hussein alayhi salam wants from us. In their way, As-Sabaya, the caravan of As-Sabaya, they were going from Kufa towards Ash-Sham. A Christian priest in the church of Martha Marotha. Martha Marotha is one of the oldest churches in the Middle East and the whole world in Aleppo in Syria. They passed by that priest. He saw the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam on that lands. He saw these pure innocent children tied with ropes and chains and they are whipped by the soldiers of Yazid. He saw all that oppression. His heart was broken. He started crying for all this oppression. He wanted to know what is going on. He went to these soldiers and he paid all this money to take the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. He took it inside the church. He cleaned it from all the blood and the dust. He put it on a perfumed silk material. He started to shed tears. Said, O head, by the light which is coming out of your face, talk to me. So the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam told and said, O Christian, say ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah and I will be your intercessor in the day of judgment. When this priest saw the head of Imam Hussein talking, he burst into crying. He hugged the head of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and said with tears in his eyes, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. These tears made the change in his heart. Another louder salawat for this love of Hussein. Those tears, those emotions changed his heart. And this change came from the emotional side towards the intellectual side. If this crying and these emotions and these tears were able to change that Christian priest, it is more powerful to change us. We the lovers of Hussein, we the Shias of Hussein, we are the sons of Hussein alayhi salam, we are in the school of Hussein alayhi salam. And we learned this love from our childhood. Our mothers were telling us from childhood, say, Ya Hussein, beat your chest, Ya Hussein. We've come years and years to this majalis. We cried to Imam Hussein. But there are certain parts until now in our heart and in our mind didn't change. Imam Hussein alayhi salam wants us to do that change. And if this change was able to affect that Christian priest, it can affect any heart of us. And this is why is the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And this is how Imam Hussein alayhi salam cured the hearts. The tragic scene of Karbala and Ashura can move any heart. Like we said yesterday, this English historian, Edward Gibbon, who died in 1794, he says, the tragic scene of the death of Hussein can awaken the sympathy in the coldest reader. He's not Muslim. But if you look at this scene, 72 children and women and companions in a very hot desert with no food and with no water. They are surrounded by 30,000. Then they slaughtered them savagely. Then they burned the tents and whip the children and take the ladies as prisoners. This will move any heart. That's why the majalis of Imam Hussein was able to change many, many people. It changed the life of many, many people who came to the majlis of Hussein alayhi salam with many dark parts in their heart, and they came out enlightened by the light of Hussein alayhi salam. Tonight I'll tell you a story about this change of Ali Gandabi. This is a very famous story in Iran. If you go to Iran and you ask them about Ali Gandabi, everyone will know Ali Gandabi, especially in the city of Hamadan. This story happened long time ago, before 80 years. This Ali Gandabi was from a very religious family. His mother always used to do the majalis of Imam Hussein in her house. And she will cook food, special food for Abbas alayhi salam. She had a special connection to Abbas alayhi salam. She will do the majalis of Abbas alayhi salam. And this Ali himself used to serve this food. He will go to neighbors and take this food and give it to neighbors and tell them, this is the nadr of Abbas. This is the nadr of al-Fadl al-Abbas alayhi salam. He grew up in such a house, full of the love of Imam Hussein and full of the love of Abbas, where they shed tears for Imam Hussein. And this is what the tear can do. But this Ali grew up, he became 17 years old and 18 years old. And unfortunately, he became a friend of some bad friends. And they changed him. Slowly, slowly, he became a gambler, a drunkard, a criminal. He became a head of a gang. And then all that village, Gandab, in Hamadan, started to complain from this Ali. In this village, they had a sheikh called Sheikh Hassan. Sheikh Hassan was invited to recite the majlis in one of the near villages. He returned after Maghrib. It was dark, and at those days, they used to close the doors of the city. Every city had a fence, like a fortress and a door. He cannot remain outside because there are wolves, and he wants to enter, but the door is closed. He reached at the door. He heard some noise, and he recognized that voice. It's the voice of Ali Gandabi, the criminal, the drunkard. He's between two difficult choices, either to remain outside to be eaten by the wolves, or to go inside and meet this criminal. But at the end, he knocked the door, and who opened for him? Ali Gandabi himself. When he opened the door, told him, Sheikh, what you are doing? In this late time, where were you? He said, I was in a near village and I recited majlis for them, and that's why I am late, I came late. He said, majlis, 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 all the years you have majalis? Every time you do majlis, it doesn't finish? He said, but Ali, Ali, this night is a very special night. He said, what is this night? He said, don't you know? This is the first night of Muharram, of Imam Hussein. When he heard the name of Muharram, the name of Imam Hussein, he remembered all those memories. He told him, I went to recite a majlis for Abbas. When he heard the name of Abbas, he remembered all these memories of his childhood, how he was crying for Abbas and for Hussein, how he was taking the food with his hands to the neighbors. His heart was broken. He started crying. He said, Shaykh, please, can you recite one majlis for me? He said, Ali, we are in the middle of the street. There is no minbar, nothing. How can I recite a majlis for you? He says, I become the minbar of Hussein. Ali sat And this sheikh sat on his back. And this sheikh recited, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah. Said, no, please sheikh, please go straight to the musibah of Abbas, to the maqtal of Abbas, to the hands of Abbas. And this sheikh started, Wallahi in qata'tumu yameeni إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني. This sheikh, he felt that there is something moving. He looked down, he saw Ali crying, bursting into crying. That night he thanked the sheikh so much and said, Inshallah, by the tears of Abbas, I will do repent. Next day, the sheikh went to the people of the village and said, Alhamdulillah, Ali Gandabi is going to repent. They went to his house, they couldn't find him. They asked his wife, he said, I want to leave to Karbala. I want to visit Al-Abbas. And he left to Karbala. And Ali Gandabi went to Karbala. First, he went to the shrine of Abbas, alayhi salam. He held the shrine of Abbas, alayhi salam. And he started to cry there, and he repented there. Then he went to shrine of Imam Hussein, alayhi salam. Then he went to Najaf. And there in Najaf, he remained. He didn't return. And he became the closest friend at that time, before 8 years, to Al-Mirza al-Shirazi, one of the greatest ulama. And slowly, slowly, he became one of his best students. And slowly, slowly, he became a alim, a scholar. Ali Gandabi, who was a gambler and a drunker, he became a scholar with Ayatollah Al-Mirza al-Shirazi. This is what the tears of change can do. Another louder salawat. He became a scholar. One day he was praying next to Ayatollah Al-Mirza al-Shirazi at that time. Everyone raised his head from sujood, but Ali Gandabi remained in sujood. After half an hour, they moved him. They found him dead. He died in the best position, in prostration. And they buried him just next to the shrine of Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, alayhi salam. How did this happen? From the tears of Imam Hussein, alayhi salam, from the weeping of Imam Hussein, alayhi salam. That's why our imams gives us all these ahadith and tells us about the great thawab of crying and weeping for Imam Hussein, alayhi salam. If this weeping was able to change that Christian priest, it can change any one of us. That Christian priest, he joined the caravan of the captives, the Sabaya, and he became Shaheed. But after that, this caravan of Sabaya moved and moved until they reached to Damascus. And there in Damascus, they entered to Bazar Sham. And in Bazar Sham, all these people of Sham, they were holding stones in their hands. They starting hitting Ahlulbayt alayhim salam with stones. They poured boiling water on Imam Zainul Abideen and Bibi Zainab. And there also there was the little Ruqayya. Ruqayya was standing at the door of the prison. She saw many children with their fathers. She said, Auntie Zainab, who are these? She said, these are the children of Sham. And who are these men who are holding their hands? They are their fathers. Dear Auntie, where is my father, Hussein? Where are they going, dear auntie? They are going to their homes. When we are going back to our home in Medina, dear auntie, Zainab, at that night, Ruqayya, in the middle of the night, saw in her dream her father, Hussein. He was wiping her hair. He was drying her tears. She said, "Dear Father Baba John, where were you? They hit my aunt Zainab. Where were you? They slapped me on my face. Where were you? I fall down from the camel. They pulled me by my hair. I was calling your name, and they were hitting me more and more." She woke up. She didn't find anything, only the dark prison. She looked right and left, no Hussein. She started to cry and cry. Zainab alayhi salam told her, "What's wrong, my dear Ruqayya?" She said, "My dear father, dear Hussein, he was just next to me. He was talking to me now. Where is he? I want him." She said, "Dear father, dear Ruqayya, he went in a long travel. He's in Safar." She kept on crying and crying. All the other children started to cry in the prison of Sham. The noise increased and reached the palace of Yazid. He said, "Who is disturbing our night? We want to enjoy our night." They told him, "The daughter of Hussein. She wants her father. That merciless man, that Yazid." She said, "Then take the head of her father to her. Take the head of Hussein." The soldier brought the head in a plate. It was covered. He put it in front of Ruqayya. She said, "I don't want any food. I don't want any drink. I just want my father Hussein." He told her, "Whatever you want is in this." She removed the cover. She was shocked to see the severed head of Abu Abdullah. With her tiny hands, with her small hands, she carried the head of Hussein. "Dear father, who has injured your forehead? Dear father, who has cut your veins? Dear father, who made me orphan in this young age? Shahida Zindana Sham, Ruqayya Jaan, Ruqayya Jaan, Ghareeba Zindana Sham, Ruqayya Jaan, Ruqayya Jaan, Sara Hussain Bar Nayzaha, Dar Kufa wa Sham Bala, Ruqayya Jaan, Ruqayya Jaan. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Wa sayalamu alladhina zalamu ala Muhammadin ayyamun qalbin yanqalibun. والعاقبة للمتقين. اللهم إنا نسألك وندعوك. We ask you by the tears of Ruqayya, by the severed head of Hussein, by the Ali Asghar of Hussein, by the hands of Abbas, الناس معي زينب الكبرى غريبة كربلاء اللهم إنا نسألك وندعوك ونتوسل إليك بأحب الخلق إليك محمد وعلي وفاطمة والحسن والحسين Raise your hands towards Allah يا الله يا الله يا يا الله يا الله All together يا الله يا الله يا الله يا الله By the tears of Ruqayya عجل لوليك الفرج والعافية والنصر اجعلنا من خير أنصاره وأعوانه والمستشهدين بين يدي اللهم أرنا الطلعة الرشيدة والغرة الحميدة واكحل نواظرنا بنظرة منا إليه Only one look to the holy face of صاحب الزمان يا الله أرنا الطلعة البهية اللهم عجل فرجا سهل مخرجا أوسع منهجا اسلك بنا محجة اللهم من كان في مجلسنا هذا صاحب حاجة My dear brothers, dear sisters, everyone who has حاجات اللهم اقضي حوائجنا يسر أمورنا فرج همومنا وغمومنا شافي مرضانا ارحم أمواتنا ولا سيما موت الحاضرين والمؤسسين الحاج حسن بن دهنيم وجميع موت المؤمنين والمؤمنات نهدي للجميع ثواب السورة المباركة الفاتحة تسبقها صلوات